Hello, this is H.D. Bailey, and welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy X! Today, we need to find some tinder for the fire there, since we got some flint earlier. If you examine the fire before getting the flint, it would say you need flint and tinder, but in this case, well, it just says we need tinder since we already got it. But if you go over here, and then press down, you can find a hidden treasure! Yeah, they tricked you with that camera angle there, but yeah, little treasure there. And if you go up here, examine that vase, or vase, whatever that thing is, thing's gotta be worth some money. Get some flowers, so I guess we could burn those. I'd prefer witches to burn, but, well, the flowers will have to do for now. Take what you can get. Better than a shark. Oh, well, actually, yeah, a sharp stick in the eye would be pretty nice about now. But anyway, okay, so one thing I also did since last time is I got the loner overdrive mode for Tidus there. Basically, the way you do that is you fight in battles alone with Tidus, and then you'll eventually get this message here. Either you just fight alone with him, or you can do the first battle in the game with Tidus and Oron, kill off Oron, and then just defend over and over and over and over again with the triangle button. And 60 rounds later, be about 2 or 3 minutes, you will have your new overdrive mode. Basically, the way it works is whenever you get your turn and Tidus is alone, your overdrive gauge will charge up. So he can use his overdrives more. And Tidus learns new overdrives by, well, using the ones he already has. So just something to keep in mind there. Now I'm just going to lay on this hard, cold rock. Maybe I can get a nice cold beer, too, while I'm at it.
I need food.
Yeah, you didn't think before you preheated the oven, huh, Tidus? Yeah, you might want to think that one through a little bit next time.
What do you want?
Gotta get your priorities straight. I want food.
It was a bad call.
Or booze.
Your team lost because of you.
You came to say that?
It's been 10 years.
Who are you anyway?
I thought you'd be crying.
You're the bouncer from the bar?
Who, me?
You cried.
What did Oron do in Xanarkand anyway? I mean, he was obviously around for a while. Tidus knew him, but, like, what was he doing there this whole time? Just like, oh yeah, I've got this sword, I'm just walking around randomly. Was he a security guard or something? Or... I don't know.
Hey, wait, wait! Don't go out on me!
Yes, talk to the fire.
Just hold on, I'll get more wood.
Sounds vulgar. Talk to the fire. Tell the fire you care. And then it won't go out on you. Whoa. Alright, it's boss time!
Give me a break!
Break me off a piece of that Kit Kat bar. Okay, so when Tidus' turn comes up, you see how his overdrive gauge charged up? That's because I set him to loner overdrive mode. So every time he gets his turn, when he's alone, it'll charge up a little bit. He doesn't have to take damage or anything. He just gets his turn. Let's show you how to use his spiral cut overdrive here. Yeah, look at that damage! Wait a minute. Back up here. That was a little too fast. Okay, so anyway, we're back here. Let's try that again. Use spiral cut on him. Now hold it. You see here, we got the cursor on the left there, and it's going to bounce right and left over and over and over and over again until either the timer runs out or you successfully press X when that cursor is on the orange part there. The more time you have left on the clock when you do that, the more damage you'll deal. So pretty simple, slow motion there. And let's give it a try, since I did it on the first try there. Yeah, that was pretty good. Let's see that again in instant replay. Ha! All right. So yeah, I just figured I'd slow it down a little bit for you guys, because I figured, well, if you're new to this game, or even JRPGs entirely, well, that might be a little confusing to someone who's new to the game. So I don't mean to insult your intelligence, viewers. I was just trying to make sure everything was explained properly and thoroughly. Whoa. Oh, what do these guys want? That's some weird hair you got there, man. Okay, more party members for boss time.
You on my side? Cool.
You got a name? No? Four letters, huh? How about I just call you Rick? Okay, Rick. Well, Rick has a new ability. Use. We can use items. Basically, kind of like a chemist in some of the other Final Fantasy games. You use an item, but, well, you can't use the item command for it. You have to use the use command. Now, what I'm doing here is I'm having Tidus attack himself, so that way I can build up Rick's overdrive gauge here. Because while Tidus is alive, that guy might hit him. So let's get Tidus dead and out of the way there, while I have Rick stealing some more grenades from this guy. The way the steal command works is the first time you attempt to steal, it's guaranteed. Each subsequent successful steal will be half that success rate. Yeah, so it'll cut it in half. So basically, what you want to do is do this over and over and over again until you get the overdrive gauge full, and as I fast forward, until we actually get to that point. Now, you don't have to do this, get her overdrive gauge full. The only reason why I'm doing this is because I want to overkill this boss and get some more items from him. But that's really only useful if you're playing the original PlayStation 2 version because of the items that you can get from him. If you're playing the HD version like me, then, well, you won't need them. Now, while I'm charging up my overdrive gauge here, one thing I do want to sort of warn you guys about is I'm actually putting annotations in the video here for some upcoming scenes. You remember that language that we saw in the previous episode? Well, we're going to be running into that more in the remainder of this episode. So I'm going to have these annotations that will tell you what they're saying if you want to know. It'll translate everything for you guys. Or otherwise, if you don't want any spoilers, you may want to turn the annotations off, viewers. So let me know what you think of this for the remainder of the LP. Okay, so I've almost got my overdrive gauge full there, so let's bring Tidus back. Use Phoenix down, and it'll revive him with 50% of his max HP there. And I'm only having Rick steal from the boss over and over again, because defending would reduce the damage he takes. So basically, just go click on mix, use two grenades. Overkill! And boom goes the dynamite, you kill the boss. When you overkill a boss, what happens is you get more ability points there, and you get more items, or double the items that you would normally get from them. In this case, ability spheres, which in the PS2 version are a lot more scarce early in the game than they are in the PS3 version here. So, but yeah, if you're playing the PS3 version, you don't have to do that. I just figured that would be nice.
Phew. That was close.
Thanks for your help.
Hey, let me go.
Redek Drak!
Fiend, Irisa, take your car!
What's going on?
For Gamed?
Well.
Fed! Trivadek Risa!
Drownia, Drakisha, Dave.
If we're petted, top we're naked for Drake.
I don't understand your alien talk.
Kuno.
What did she do? Punch him in the stomach with a 1-inch punch or something? I don't know. But yeah, it's a girl. I knew it was a girl the whole time, viewers. I'm not that dumb. I mean, I have played this game like 7 times before. So. No, I don't know if that's the exact number of times. I just know I've played it a lot of times. Enough to know what's going on. So I hope you guys like the annotations I put in there. And I'll be putting in more here. But,
Kid, get digest.
Hey, that hurts.
Osujek, rain?
Whoa. Okay.
Okay. Just stay still. Wow.
Kindness.
What's with the hair, man?
Right. Whatever.
Do you speak English? Maybe they speak what? Say what again?
I don't understand.
Fed! He said you can stay if you make yourself useful.
You understand me?
Yeah, it's magic.
Alright, I'll work.
It's the magic universal translator. No. But one thing you want to do, you talk to this guy, he'll give you some potions. And if you go over here, you can get the Albed Primer. It's a note or a book or whatever that lets you learn a little bit of the Albed language, which is the language that these guys are speaking here. And we get a little trophy for that. All right.
Oh, almost forgot.
Oh yeah, she's going to give us a little tutorial on the sphere grid, which is how you develop your characters. But I'll skip that. Okay, we're back, and don't talk to the guy on the right there, or you'll have to go through the tutorial again.
Ancient ruins right beneath us. It's not active now, but there should still be some power left. We're gonna go down there and activate it.
Sure.
And then we should be able to salvage the big prize.
What's the worst that could possibly happen?
Okay, let's get to work.
How do you know he can even swim? Well, I guess it works, so. No scuba gear or anything for Titus here. Now, I do want to show you one thing. Now, on this screen, you press the square button, you get back up here.
We'll go as soon as you're ready.
Okay, so, what I... What? No! What I want to do is go over here, talk to this guy. Okay. That was the guy who gave us the potions there, remember? You get back on the ship, he doesn't do anything new for you. But if you go down here, you hold the circle button, and then down to go down here, you go over to this screen here, then come back, and once you're there, then you can get back on the ship real fast, even though you're still underwater.
We'll go as soon as you're ready.
And talk to that guy who gave us the potions again. He'll give us 3 more potions. And you can do that infinitely if you wanted to. Not that I really need to do that, but, well, it's there. So let's make another little save file there. Awesome. Oh, and you know what? Let's put that sphere grid to use. Basically, you move, you go up to a node, use an ability sphere, boom, you get a new ability. Ability spheres are relatively rare early in the game, which is why I wanted to overkill that boss there. But in the PS3 version, there's much easier ways of getting them. I just figured I'd demonstrate methods for people who are playing different versions of the game. And getting the extra ability points is nice, too. Normally, I'm not going to go that far out of my way to overkill a boss or even random enemies like I'm about to do here. For the vast majority of the game, we're going to keep it nice and simple. Just that early in... I just want to check something there. Yeah, it's just that early in the game, it's... Because we only have one or two party members, it's relatively difficult to overkill enemies without going out of your way for it. But I do think it is worthwhile very early in the game. So now what I want to do here is I want to steal grenades from these guys. Why fish have grenades, I don't know, but we'll just keep on doing that. Oh, by the way, you can steal infinitely from these guys, or any enemy, really. But remember, you're going to have 50% chance of succeeding each subsequent time. So it's going to be practically impossible to eventually keep on getting more items out of them. So anyway, what I want to do with these guys is I want to use cheer over and over and over again, up to 5 times. What cheer does is it raises your attack and defense by 1 each for your entire party there. So that effectively raises my damage, which allows me to potentially overkill them. In order to overkill these piranhas, you need to deal at least 225 damage when you kill them. Which is well more than enough to kill them, actually. Okay, I think that's 5. I might have miscounted while I was talking there. Well, whatever. Hey, all right, go, Rick. So anyway, oh, crap. I meant to have Titus kill that one. Well, anyway, you saw how Titus overkilled that other one. You get a little more AP, and we got monospheres from the one I overkilled, but not from the one that I didn't. So, well, I got 2 from the one and only 1 from the other. So, oh well, not a big deal that I lost out on one there. But still, generally in this game, you really want to overkill things as much as possible. I'm not going to do that throughout the game, like I said, but with piranhas, I want to cheer 5 times before having Titus kill them, because they can potentially drop ability spheres, which, after this point in the game, are going to be very difficult to acquire in the PS2 version. So you probably would want to do that. So, but otherwise, yeah, I mean, if you don't want to do that, you don't have to. It's just something I'm doing for now, early in the game. Later in the game, I will have much more efficient ways of overkilling enemies. And I'm not going to go out of my way to overkill every single thing. Just the monsters that I think have good stuff that are worth overkilling for. Whoa. Okay, that was just another random battle against piranhas. Figured I'd edit that out for you guys so you didn't have to... Game? Come on. Can I activate this thing? There you go. Is that your solution to everything, Titus? Banging on things? Need fire? Bang rocks together. Computer won't work? Bang on it a few times. Girls won't kiss you? Bang them. I mean... Banging works for everything for you, apparently. Whoa! What the hell is that thing? Find out next time on Let's Play Final Fantasy X! This is HD Bailey, signing off. Have a good day!